Okay, I can't stop talking about this with Chad Myers. Okay, imagine. Imagine being able to fly anywhere in the world in under an hour. Sounds unreal, right? Think again. The Pentagon's new ride, it's called the Falcon Hypersonic Test Vehicle 2, or HTV-2 for short. This experimental unmanned aircraft could travel from New York to L.A. in a cool 12 minutes. Today's test flight, by the way, attempt number two here, lifted off earlier today from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. Here's how it's supposed to work. An Air Force rocket boosts the HTV-2 to the edge of space, much like a space shuttle. The aircraft separates from the rocket. It re-enters the atmosphere and reaches speeds up to 13,000 miles an hour. I've got Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr standing by, also Chad Myers standing by as well. But Barbara, first to you. You know, this sounds amazing, but today's test flight, not a success. They lost contact with this thing. What happened?
Oh, it didn't work too well, did it? It turns out after about 9 minutes in flight, this unmanned vehicle, basically they did lose contact with it. No electronic signals going back and forth between the vehicle and ground controllers. Their working assumption now is that it basically sort of self-detonated and it splashed down in the Pacific Ocean exactly how it's supposed to. But Brooke, 13,000 miles an hour, Mach 20, the friction it creates is something like 3,500 degrees Fahrenheit on the skin of the aircraft. I guess one of the questions is, does it fly faster than Superman? I think we're still looking into that.
I don't know that yet. We'll have to find him and track him down and ask. But Mach 20, that's kind of fast. But why are they doing this? I mean, we may have a little fun with this in a moment. But, I mean, this is just for research. This would just be for the military, right? This would never be meant for sticking someone in this thing.
Well, I think most of us would be, you know, a lot of anti-sickness pills. I won't be too cavalier about it. It is trying to test this concept of hypersonic military technology in all candor. What they want to do is see if they can actually prove that they can fly at these speeds. What does that mean? It means the military could deliver weapons to a target anywhere in the world within 1 hour. That's the kind of response time that the military is looking for, obviously in a very serious security crisis, that it can put a bomb on target 1 hour from launch, 1 hour from making the decision. That's a very futuristic concept, but it's one of the things they're really looking at down the road. It means you don't have to deploy tens of thousands of troops possibly halfway around the world. If you can do this, that's the instant response the military of the future wants, Brooke.
That is amazing, Mach 20. Barbara Starr, thank you. I'm bringing in Chad Myers. We had an interesting conversation earlier behind the scenes over, obviously, as Barbara, you know, illuminated, that there's no way this would be for human flight whatsoever, 3,500 degrees Fahrenheit, forget about it. But we were talking, you know, in terms of Gs, right? You had been on a Blue Angels flight that got up to
7.6.
And how did you fare?
The vision in my eyes started going away. This is only 10 seconds worth of 7.6 pull, right? So the vision started going away. I had about that much to see, and then it all turned black and white and got all sparkly, and then the pilot pulled out, and then I could see again. But I was doing this thing called the Hick maneuver. The Hick, because Blue Angels, they don't let you use G-suits. They don't use G-suits, and they say, if you're going to fly with us, you're not using one either.
Okay.
So you like, grunt to keep the blood in your head. And you, it's like, you know, turning
like you're slamming a tennis ball, that kind of grunt.
Like you're just trying to push everything, you know, like your entire face is turning red because the blood's coming back up. If you're not doing it, though, you're going to pass out. All the blood is going to be in your bottom or in your feet because all of your G-forces are down. Now, the G-forces on this plane would be enormous, maybe 20, 30 Gs, which would be like you hitting yourself into an embankment, a concrete embankment in your car. That's how instantaneous.
So you were able to do 6-7 G's in a Blue Angel just because I don't mind making fun of myself. Let's go ahead, pull up the video of when I was in space camp a couple weeks ago, months ago, whenever I was there, and I got on the centrifuge because, you know, astronauts, when they're launching up into space, they go 3, max 4 G's. Mm-hmm. So here I am in the centrifuge. We're supposed to be going 3.2. This poor kid, Clayton, sitting next to me, he was so excited to go around, whipping around this thing, and I tell you what, I lasted 3 G's, and then I was like waving the proverbial red flag. Plus, my crew had me eating lunch before this thing. Nothing happened, but I think that was a cruel joke. Point being, I have such respect for people who can endure that.
Yes, and this vehicle that we, I want to call it a vehicle because it isn't a plane.
Right.
It looks
like a
plane.
Rocket.
It's a rocket. It's the end of a rocket that shoots off. It drops back down into the atmosphere. And what they're trying to do, it's not that we can't go Mach 20. We've never gone Mach 20 in the atmosphere. You can go in space Mach 20 because there's no drag. There's no air up there. But this thing literally tears air apart. I know you love that term.
I do.
It disassociates oxygen. It disassociates nitrogen as that 3,500 degree edge of the front wing hits that air. It literally rips it apart. There's no laminar flow. There's no Bernoulli principle. You know what that is? You know I can take this piece of paper and make it go up?
I remember that.
It goes up because that's the lift. I'm making lower atmosphere pressure. That has nothing to do with hypersonic.
It's amazing. We got to try again. 12 minutes, New York, LA. It's very impressive. We'll be watching for from the Department of Defense.
They're more important. They're more impressed with going from our side of the world to the other side of the world
in under an hour
rather than New York to LA.
Chad Myers, thanks for having a little fun.
You're welcome.